Hello and welcome to Innovators. This is the podcast that gets the stories behind some of your favorite products. I'm Bradley Hasemeyer. Today, I get the chance to talk with James Howell. He is the GM of device marketing from Microsoft, and we're talking about their newest announcements involving an AI laptop. What does that even mean? Let's get into it. All right, James Howell, thank you so much for being here. For those of you who aren't watching us, but you should because we're a video podcast, James looks like a kid in a candy store who just came out with a backpack full of candy. He is relieved and excited because you guys just put on the largest event that you've done in what, like nearly two decades? Tell me about what you're feeling right now and what just happened.
Yeah, I'm pumped, Bradley. It's good to see you. Thank you. Yeah. Excited, tired, elated, all at the same time. It's, to put it in perspective, we just toasted about 200 press and analysts. First time we have brought that group to Microsoft's campus since we launched Windows 7. And we thought it was that big of a momentous event that we were bringing them to our place, bringing our campus, showing them what we've done with a behind-the-scenes look.
Amazing. Obviously, lots of announcements that came out, and some people will be aware and some people won't. So it has been very hush-hush, and I'm super excited to be talking about it today.
Yeah, maybe I give a little context.
Yeah.
We've been working on releasing a whole new category of PCs.
Okay.
That brings AI into it. When we first began this, we started talking with partners 3 years ago. It was before, you know, ChatGPT was live and people were like, AI PCs, that sounds like a terrible thing.
Yeah, that's hilarious how quickly things change. I mean, obviously the tech space just moves.
Totally. And we see this as that new moment. There is some new hardware coming to a PC. We have CPUs and GPUs and RAM and storage. There's a new thing called an MPU. And we're going to offload things to it so we can run AI tasks to change how you use a PC.
Is there a product name for this laptop that we're talking about here?
So we've launched Copilot Plus PCs, the new most intelligent, most performant PCs you can buy.
This is a real kind of milestone moment, right? Like this is going to be something that people will look back on and say, now, do you remember when our computers weren't this way, right?
That's right.
I love that. So is there a range of these different laptops, like an 18-inch, a 6-inch? Like what is? Talk to me about all that too.
So I have one sitting here.
Ooh, come on.
So this, I'll try to get it right here in the camera.
Yeah.
This is the new Surface laptop.
It's beautiful.
The 13-inch. There's a 15-inch and a 13-inch.
That's a really beautiful machine.
Beautiful display, 600 nits, HDR quality display. 22 plus hours of battery life.
Wow. Like,
there is other products also coming from all of our OEM partners, Acer, Asus, Dell, HP, Lenovo, Samsung. They're all bringing products. Those products, most of them are available for pre-order today from Best Buy, and many of them will be on shelf starting on June 18th.
And how are they all running that same, essentially the same brains? Is that how that kind of is working in terms of AI into some of these other products?
Yeah, so we've been partnering with all the silicon providers. The first ones out of the gate will come with Qualcomm, a Snapdragon Elite series processor. And why Qualcomm? Like Qualcomm has a long history of MPUs. They've actually been building them into cars, into cameras, into all types of products around the globe. So we partnered with them and say, how can we bring that to the PC and leverage Microsoft's strength in AI to do powerful things on the local PC? We're using a new class of chip. The new class of chip is far more efficient and it's more performant. So you get more performance, better battery life. It's almost always silent. It has a fan, but for me, it never turns on. I don't hear it. You know, you don't hear those fans kicking in where you're like, I don't know what happened. My machine's about to take off.
Yes.
And it brings you these new AI experiences that speed up my time.
Amazing.
It takes the average person about 5 to 8 hours a week just to find what they were doing before and get them back to where they were. With a Copilot Plus PC, we are launching a new feature called Recall. Recall will instantly bring forward anything that you've done before. And it uses it with the understanding, I like to call it AI memory. So, you know, I have memory and it's just instant. I can instantly remember, oh, here's what I was doing last week, et cetera. I can pull it forward and think about it. my AI memory is like a photographic memory. Remembers everything that I've ever seen on my computer. It puts it in context, and it's my personal photographic AI memory because it's only for me, stored locally on my machine, and I can bring it back to the instant of anything that I want. And I'll give you a good example with, so my daughter just went to prom.
Great, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes.
Over the course of, 2 weeks, I had seen, 100 different dresses. I'm sure that she'd looked at over 200 dresses.
Wow.
And I remember the moment she was like, hey, Dad, I know the dress, but I can't find it.
Oh, boy. I feel like a recall moment is coming up.
And I literally, luckily, I was like, okay, describe it for me.
Amazing.
And she's like, hey, Dad, it was black, it was backless, and it had these sparkly sequins. No search history is going to come up with that.
You're going to get a million hits on just a generic search.
100%. And I mean, she'd looked at hundreds, if not thousands of dresses across dozens of websites. And being able to go in and say, black dress, backless, sparkly with sequins was the search. And, you know, it pulled up about 15 different dresses because there was enough of them that looked close enough to that.
Sure.
But she's like, that's it. That's the one. And this was something, you know, it would have taken her, me, because, you know, she would have come to me and said, Dad, you got to find this. I know I looked at it.
I know it's this one. And you're like, what's the difference? It looks like this one, but she knows it.
Yes. And that moment, it was magical. We need to get that to desktops. We need to get it to all-in-ones, gaming machines, machines with DGPUs like NVIDIA RTX. Got to get it to, you know, a $500-$600 laptop. And that's going to take us, you know, a couple of years to get it across everything or anything you would buy.
That's amazing. I love that. And what a great use case scenario. I think our listeners can relate to those types of things, right? It's not just that you want to have fun and be like, hey, you know, tell me some jokes. I love what you're talking about, this perspective that you're just here to help the customer. It's not to entertain the customer, though that will happen. It's not to just be like kind of like fireworks and fanciness and, you know, claiming you're on the cutting edge, but it's like, we're doing this because it makes your life easier and everyone's looking for that. So that's really neat.
That's right. And that's why I love what I do. Like I look at what I'm doing and I'm like, man, this will make my life easier, my family, my friends, and hopefully everybody.
And what do you say when you're at the dinner party? I know you're a dad of five and you're planning a vacation, maybe not a lot of dinner parties recently, but you're there, hypothetically speaking, and you get the pushback, AI is going to take over the world. AI is taking our jobs. AI, you know, like that kind of version, that side of the coin. What's your take on that?
I like to think about it in practical things I can think about and kind of grok. And I think of when I was younger, I still remember the first time that we walked into a grocery store and there was cameras, security cameras everywhere.
Right.
And, you know, I turned to my mom and my mom looked at me and she's like, maybe we shouldn't shop here anymore because there's security cameras. Like,
what are they going to do with the cameras?
Oh, no. Yeah, what are they going to do with the footage? Like, now we're recorded and everywhere. And, you know, now you'd walk into any...
you can't go to a gas station without a camera on
anywhere. Yeah, and there'd be a camera and we just don't even fear it. And I just really believe AI is going to be so useful, so valuable that we won't fear it. But we do need to be responsible with how we use it and how we build with it.
One of the reasons I love doing this show is that I come out so much smarter. So I appreciate you and congrats. It's got to feel so relieving and exciting for what's to come.
Yeah, it's a wonderful moment. And thank you, Bradley. Thanks for the time and appreciate your viewers and hope they're all excited. And go try and give us feedback on ways we can evolve this. We want to make this better for each of our users.
I love that. Awesome. Well, thank you so much. Have a great rest of your day and we'll see you on the next one.
Awesome. Thanks.
Well, there you go. Hopefully you're smarter. I'm definitely smarter. Thanks so much for watching and or listening. Make sure you subscribe to the show because we've got a lot more coming your way where we have all of your favorite products. But for now, keep exploring, innovating, and embracing your future.